Today on Toy Shiz, a tanning bed expert in a loincloth rides a giant green armored tiger. Let's talk toys. Welcome back, everyone. Toy Shiz here, and I am back yet again to give you guys another fresh look, courtesy of my friends over at Mattel. They sent over the new He-Man. I actually found the Battle Cat at Target. We're going to take a look at both these figures today. Very cool Battle Cat. Humongous packaging. Like I said, he is hitting Target stores now. Also went up on the Target app. Nice green on this guy. I'm excited to check this out. Very cool packaging. I like this. It's different, has a presence on the shelf. The artwork on these boxes are absolutely gorgeous. And if you're interested, go check out Eamon O'Donohue on Instagram, the self-described devastatingly handsome artist of all things cool. Go check out his artwork because he absolutely nailed it on all things He-Man on this stuff. Here's a bit of a bio for Battle Cat if you want to screen grab it. And then you can also see, take the armor off, and you got a big old cringer right there, the cowardly little tiger. And just to make sure you're all paying attention, I do have all these characters and we'll be taking a look throughout the rest of the week. Wink, wink. Here's some more artwork of Battle Cat on the other side of the box. And here's the barcode as well. Like I said, once again, this guy is at Target store. So nice presentation, very excited, but I know you're all here to finally check out He-Man. Masked Universe Revelation, the new Netflix cartoon that's coming in July. I'm very excited. Bonnie has gotten me excited for this new cartoon. It's the best looking He-Man I think I've ever seen, and I'm just getting into He-Man with the Origins line. The backside of the box shows all the cross cells. Again, gorgeous artwork, very cool, very powerful, very striking presence of artwork on there, and here's the barcode as well. If you're wondering, the four of these, He-Man, Mossman, Skeletor, and Evil-Lyn, will all hit Walmart stores come summertime, and then once they've kind of hit, so Walmart gets the four figures, Target gets Skele-God and the Battle Cat, once they've hit the stores for a little bit, then they'll go everywhere. So each one gets their own little half of the wave, whatever. Anyways, I'm very excited. This is cool. Very excited for the cartoon. Sit back, relax, grab yourself a nice hot cup of coffee. This is a look at the brand new Masters of the Universe Revelation Battle Cat and He-Man by Mattel. And while I got you guys here, please do consider subscribing if you haven't already. Old toys, new toys, daily news updates. I guarantee you'll find something here that you like. Now, good news real fast for you collectors that maybe want to take them out and kind of put them back in. If you go at the top of the box, just simply slice the piece of tape, you fold it back, Battle Cat, you'll find a little secret message, but you can pull the trays out and put each of the figures, Battle Cat, He-Man, any of them. He-Man does have like a clamshell so you can keep him nice and secure, so it's a nice way to repackage the figures. And here they both are out of the packaging. Finally, we get to see He-Man up against the new Battle Cat. Now I'm going to tell you this right off the bat. I'm not going to go into, oh, this should be like this or this should be like this. The size between these two, A-okay, works for me. I'm going purely off of what I see for He-Man Revelation. That's my new favorite He-Man cartoon, and I haven't even seen it yet. It's the best I think I've ever seen the characters look. I'm not into Filmation, but this looks very cool to me, and I really like the animated style that they went with. I love when they match the cartoons. So for Battle Cat, I should say Cringer, right? Minus the armor. Very nicely sculpted and a lot of articulation on this guy. I mean, super articulated. When I was talking about the Origins Battle Cat, he's got the ankle rockers and everything that I really wanted so he can kind of get that rear up motion, which I'll show you later. But I like that the jaw opens and closes. I like the face. It's a very meek, very mild, not cowardly looking Cringer as I've seen, but you get some nice head and neck articulation. You can get him looking up, looking to the side, twist the head, twist the neck. So a very wide range of motion on this guy. The arms work nicely for me as well. They'll kind of sort of ball joint out to the sides, which is good. They don't go all the way out, but they'll go out just enough. He'll spin it. We're just going to say the elbow, for lack of a better animal anatomy, whatever, but she gets a twist there. And then the ankle rocker, hand rocker, whatever you want to say, paw rocker. That's where, there you go. He can twist. He can do all that cat maneuvers right there at the upper diaphragm, whatever you want to say. Lower diaphragm, he can twist as well. Very articulated, as I'll just say over and over again. So right off the bat, it works for me and what I like. The tail is articulated. the legs do the same thing as the front paws, right? And you can twist them at the knee, the hind legs, whatever you want to call it. Don't do that thing on the comments where you're like, this is the actual anatomy, right? All the articulation you could need, this guy has it in spades. When it comes to the armor piece, I actually like the color on this. I like the eyes. I wish you could do something where you could take the eyes out or move them up. I don't know what you would do just to have like a helmet so it doesn't have the eyepiece. It's a very flexible rubber, which has worked really well. And especially when you put He-Man on him, like the saddle right here, this is cool. Kind of has the old-fashioned look, right? We just take the belts and kind of put them around the underside of the Battle Cat, and you just attach them. It's very simple, very self-explanatory. But, yeah, you just put the saddle right on the back of him. You harness, like, it's so 80s. That's what I really like about this. You don't really see a lot of this stuff anymore, but very cool. You just kind of notch them in there, get them all secure. And once you have it, yeah, the saddle becomes a working Battle Cat saddle. And you'll find that sometimes the saddle will kind of go back, go forward. It'll move around. Very rarely did I find it that moving him around undid the belts, maybe once or twice. But you put the helmet on him and he looks menacing. You put the mouth open. It's a cool looking Battle Cat. The new He-Man comes with a pair of hands. So you get a fisted hand, you get a weapon holding hand, so two weapon holding hands. And then the actual He-Man himself, I think that they did a pretty good job of making it look like the animation. He comes with the power sword, same exact power sword that Skele-God comes with. Ah, I wonder what's going on there. That's what those figures are meant to do. You don't have to say it's spoilers. You could just say, oh, I wonder what's gonna happen in this new show. The shield on this guy is really cool. I like that he has just the belts on one side to slip over his arm. It's got the classicness to it. It works for me. And then the actual figure is done nicely. He's got the boots. He's got the H He-Man thing or Iron Cross or whatever it was. He's got peg holes on the bottom of his feet. He's also got numbers on the bottom of his feet if you're interested in that. And overall, much like Battle Cat, I'd say the articulation works out really nicely. The arms, they go all the way up and they go all the way down to the side. He's got double jointed elbows. He's got biceps swivel. He rotates at the hands. You'll see right here. So you can pop the hand off. You can slip this little piece off. He only comes with one of these classic bands. So maybe if you have to do a classic He-Man, you might want to get two. I don't know. I think that they should have added one of those extra bands just to keep it that extra classic He-Man. But the diaphragm will turn. It's a little stuck. We'll just say he rotates more at the waist for me. I wouldn't say that it goes too far forward and too far back. So you get minimal articulation there. His legs will kick out to the side. Go easy on him. He's got thigh swivel. And then he also has double jointed knees. He will swivel at this furry boot right there. And he has some really good ankle rockers. They're not loose like Skele-God's, but they are nice and tight. Now go easy with these legs because it kind of freaked me out at first when I was putting him on Battle Cat. It's kind of an awkward thing at first. He will put his leg out, just go easy. Sometimes you kind of have to rock the legs back into place. You let me know how it goes on yours, but that's what I found works for me. He holds the power sword well. The one gripe is that I wish you could make it to where he looks up a whole heck of a lot better to look at the power sword and then have it to where he could put the power sword up in that hand. You know what I mean? Because otherwise it's kind of slanted at the side. For putting this guy on Battle Cat, it's very, very simple. And you just kind of, you know, put his legs out to the side and you're just going to simply, in so many words, straddle Battle Cat. And he fits on there nicely. And I think, again, for me, I don't think Battle Cat's too big. I prefer a giant, huge Battle Cat. That makes sense to me, a barbarian guy riding into battle. I don't want like a teeny tiny Battle Cat. So for me, it's cool. And you kind of just have to situate the legs. I think that's why the saddle is rubber, because you can kind of push the legs in to hold him on better. But once you have him in place, I think it looks great. He-Man riding a giant Battle Cat into battle, and that's just dang cool. It's so dang 80s. You just gotta blast Bonnie Tyler right now just to harness the coolness. You can totally get Battle Cat on his hind legs. You gotta just figure it out. Situate the tail, the legs, He-Man just holding the mighty power sword, all that kind of stuff. It's straight from the Entertainment Weekly promo stills. In terms of the scaling, I would say, because I have Skele-God, right? I think that I mean, based on what I see, I would first Skele-God to be huge and menacing over He-Man. So, yeah, he's about an inch taller. He-Man's at the 7-inch, and Skele-God is at the 8-inch mark. So it works for me. Here is Skele-God with Battle Cat. We haven't seen the show. I don't know. Here are the many iterations of Battle Cats that I have, from the first to the Origins and now to Revelation. And they're all different, all unique. Some have no articulation, some do. If you wanted to see the Revelation on the Origins, I guess that works for the most part. I just think he's a little bit too big for the Origins. Origins on a Revelation, that's fine, but I think that they all have their own place for their own Battle Cats, to be quite honest with you, and that's really cool to see over time. And then, scaling-wise, like I said, He-Man's at 7-inch, so yeah, Spawn is just a tad bit taller. He goes well with the DC Multiverse McFarlane toys. He will probably fit in with various NECA figures as well. Marvel Legends, because He-Man is taller than most, I would say that he will work for the most part if you wanted to go that route. I don't know why, but yeah, I would say that he fits. And for the one guy that'll probably ask me, here he is next to a Ghost Rider Lego. I got you, precious. And of course, here he is next to the new Skeletor Revelations. And because I know people will ask me, here's the Origins head on top of this new He-Man, and it works for the most part. The skin tone might be a little bit off, if you can kind of see, but it actually is kind of cool. I don't mind it at all. I think it works. I think it's darn cool. It's a lot better than this. Kill me. And if you were wondering, the power sword does slip into the back of his He-Harness. That's what we're calling it from now on. That's awesome. And it looks good, and you can put his arm back like he's going to pull it out and do I have the power, and yeah, that's cool. So I'm very happy with this He-Man. This is a very cool set of toys. If you've never been into He-Man, you're kind of getting into it. Maybe you just got the Origins. Origins, I think, is still my preferred, but I do like this. I'll be quite honest with you. So that's really going to wrap it up for my look at the brand new Mattel Masters of the Universe He-Man, MOTU, Revelation, He-Man, and Battle Cat. I think you're going to end up with two stellar-looking toys. One thing I'll point out about He-Man, he's kind of got the Owen Wilson nose. I think that the head sculpt could have been just a little bit more on model to the show, because as you'll see with other figures, they nailed it with those. He-Man is the only one that kind of is a little bit off in the face. As far as the articulation goes on both, definitely meets my needs. The fact that you can do the things from the trailer and everything else, that is very cool. I like the cartoon look for this He-Man. I can't wait to watch the show. This gets me excited. It gets me hyped. It's good old-fashioned marketing. You got a cartoon coming, and you got some toys as well. As long as the story is there, duh. The animation is already killer, so as long as the story rocks, I am great. But I'm curious to know what you guys think about these new He-Man toys. Are they for you? Will you be grabbing? Comment below, let me know. Let's talk everything He-Man Revelation. And again, thank you to Mattel for sending these over to give you guys this fresh look. And I'm gonna leave you guys with that. As always, drink some great coffee, eat some great food, but most importantly, remember, these are toys. They're not meant to be taken so seriously. Have fun. Have fun with the cartoon. Watch it. Don't watch it. Collect the toys. Don't collect the toys. Just have fun and have a great time doing it. And when you do, let me know what you found. I'll talk to you guys soon. Adios.